So this topic covers Azure Resource Health and kind of an overall view of how you can see how all your resources are doing and if a recent event has happened. And so Kale's going to take us through actually where to find this this page or this blade, I guess, and how you can view all those things on all your different Azure resources. So Kale, if you want to show us how to access that.
Yeah, so I think that's a good kickoff, Ed, around the actual importance of this resource health. So I think this is like one of the best kept secrets inside Azure, because if you don't know it's there, you probably wouldn't even be looking for it. But actually what this does is it's a really important service, like Ed said. It can show you things like, hey, my VM went down yesterday. I got an alert. You know, I had some alert set up to say if my machines go down, and let's say it's an IaaS VM, why did it go down? So in the past, you could go look and it would show, yes, in your audit logs, you would see the VM went down. And then you would see it come back up. And then you would say, what happened? Why did it go down? And you could comb through the event logs on the virtual machine and you may not find anything. So you say, what happened? Why did my VM go down? And so this was created. So it's kind of hidden. So if you go into your portal, and actually I'm going to zoom in here because this is kind of hard to see. So up here in the top corner, when you're in the portal, you see all these little icons. The one that has the question mark on it is for help. And this is where you'd open a support request if you wanted to do things with your account. But the important one here is this help and support. So it's right here. So if you go under this guy, it actually opens up this blade. And this allows you to go ahead and open support requests and all that. But it also has this tile here for resource health. So if you go under there, and again, these are, you see the little heading here that these are 15-minute delay. But this will show you the health of all the stuff that you have running in Azure right now. So I have some web applications, actually an API, a mobile, and a web app. And I have some virtual machines and a SQL server running. Now, the SQL is still doing something, so it looks like it's still trying to determine the health of that because that's something I just provisioned recently. But these will all show up. And what's cool is you can actually drill through, and it'll tell you if everything's good. Now, if something was bad, like let's say something happened to one of my virtual machines, and I have an external, you know, monitoring service, or I'm using Azure's alert service to say, hey, alert me if X happens on this VM, like the CPU goes to zero or the machine goes down, these kind of things. We could come in here right away, so the support guys would get the alert and say, hey, the VM's down. And they would say, okay, so what happened? Hurry up, you know, there's always this scramble around what happened to the virtual machine. So they could come in here and actually look and see, and this would actually show up as like a kind of red or degraded. And when they click on it, they could see what happened. Now, in my case, everything looks nice. But in the real world, you know, when things happen, people would say, what happened yesterday? Last night I saw the VM go down. What happened? Somebody could come in and look at this, and it would show you the last time that something happened on this VM. Like, let's say a machine went down. It would say it went down for planned maintenance. Well, then you were ignoring the email alerts. Like, we send email alerts that say, hey, this weekend or in the next 72 hours, we're going to patch these VMs. You're one of them. And if you ignore that and then your virtual machine goes down, you might say, what happened? The only way you could tell that is to know that what our patch schedule was, and this will surface that kind of stuff for you. So it's a really cool tool for you to kind of troubleshoot when you start to see things that maybe you don't understand is happening in your environment. Like, why did this happen? There's another part to this that kind of feeds into it. On the virtual machine itself, we actually have a service. So if you actually go onto the virtual machine and pass a specific URL, you can actually see the same data that's coming back here. So there's actually an extension running on that virtual machine by default that's actually harnessing this data to say, hey, I'm about ready to go down because of planned maintenance, or maybe it's something else like storage crashed. So if we had like a storage outage or something inside Azure and maybe your VM was affected, you would see that surfaced here as well. So it kind of eliminates some of the guesswork whenever you start to see things that are anomalies inside Azure. And it's a great place for you to go. I think it's so hidden because it's up under the help menu, but I think it's really good for people that have a lot of resources deployed out to Azure. And so that wraps the module on Azure Resource Health.